Hi everyone, it is great to be back here. So exciting to be live from Maui, at the not so secret location I talked about on our Instagram. It's amazing to be here and really fun to share the Maui magic with you all today. We've got a fun live stream planned. We're gonna be talking about how you can support the bees during fall and winter months. And then Camera Guy is gonna be on here in just a second and share a little bit more about what we're doing here in Maui. So hello, we've missed you all. It's been, I wanna say 3 weeks or so since we've live streamed. You can see the beautiful view behind us. So glad that you're enjoying it, super peaceful. We're really feeling the Maui vibes here and enjoying the aloha spirit that is so prevalent here on the islands. I think every single person we run into just has that beautiful aloha giving attitude and vibe, and people are so friendly and so kind. And thank you so much for joining us today. So I wanna say hello to those of you that are here. It's great to see so many of our regular people here today. Charlene, great to be here. Nisha and Cliff, of course, our moderators. Here's Camera Guy here.
Aloha everyone, in the chat. Thank you for joining us.
So yeah, thank you so much. We're gonna see if, I don't know if the picture will change at all on the live, probably not, huh? It's a little bit blown out in the background. I don't know if you can fix that. But anyway, my backyard gourds, hello, the healing berry. Luz, great to have you here. Santa Ana Road Wildman. Oh, there we go. Awesome to be here, to have you here today. I know you're usually working on a Monday. And Amy, wonderful to have you. And Felicia, first live chat. That's awesome. Hey, you couldn't ask for a better spot to join us first here in the island of Maui. Normally we're home in Southern California, but we're here on a working vacation. So Camera Guy is gonna tell a little bit more about that.
Yes, let me see if I can get that back to a little bit.
The lighting there, keeps. Maybe we have to turn it a little bit.
I don't know, but I wanted y'all to see the water, man. Sorry for showing you my hand.
The light keeps going off and on. Maybe we can switch, I think, to this way might be a little better. No? Okay, well, we'll do what we can.
Try touching up where the water would be.
The light keeps changing on us. Okay.
Anyway, just want to tell you all, I wanted to stop for a minute. I'm doing sound over there, making sure Kim sounds good and all that stuff. But I wanted to stop and take a minute and just tell you all, thank you so much for following along with us on our Show the World Your Garden tour. We started in Costa Mesa. Now we're out here in the islands, and we're bringing you episodes and stuff and some episodes of our hikes as well. So I just wanted to tell you, thank you so much for your comments, for following along and watching. It's so encouraging to hear that you are enjoying it. Even the hiking ones that aren't so much Show the World Your Garden, but exploring wherever it is that we're at. So again, thank you so much for that. I also wanted to let you know that we have yet another trip to make from here. That's all I'm going to tell you. So we're not done with episodes here out in the islands. That's all I'm going to say.
Should be done.
Along with that, if you want to follow us on Instagram, Nisha, if you wouldn't mind putting our Instagram names in there, that would be great right now. But we do show a little bit more off-camera things that don't quite make it or fit into the videos. So you might want to watch for that. Even if you're not a big Instagrammer, you can just follow along and just watch, you know, that would be a fun thing. So we do a lot of that kind of content as well. And we just want to bring you all along and just share this with you all and just show you other parts of the world in case you never get a chance to go there.
That's right.
That's it.
Really want to share it with you. And like Jerry mentioned, it's a working vacation. We've got our computers. We're working. Sending out emails. Yeah. We have the Cali Kim team working at our home office, still sending out orders.
Yep.
Tending to the garden. So the seed shop is definitely still open, but we are on a working vacation here, but really enjoying it. Just relaxing a little bit then working as well.
Sorry. Yeah, a perfect example of why it would be cool for you to watch us on Instagram as well is because I brought all the gear. Just right inside here, I've got, you know, all the cameras, the GoPros, the drones, I got everything. And I'm going to make a little reel about all the gear that I brought. I got Kim set up out here. We've got equipment down here. So yeah, this is very much a working type trip / vacation. And on Instagram, I'll take you behind the scenes and show you that type of thing.
All right. Definitely. So thanks for all the great comments. So glad that you all are enjoying it with us. And we really did want to bring you along and include you on our trip. So thanks for hanging out with us.
Okay, I'm back to the sound over there just to make sure Kim has good sound, and I'll see you guys around. Okay, bye.
Okay. If you think we should turn this a little bit to get the lighting better, let me know. Although, actually, if I move over here, it looks pretty good. Okay, guys, so one of my favorite experiences so far of the trip. Well, we've had so many great ones. We went out to see Debbie Wheeler, who is normally here on the lives, but I think she's visiting her son at the moment. We went out to see her beautiful garden, tropical garden, and it's so fun to see all the tropical fruit and vegetables. And also, one of the big highlights was visiting Maui Bee Farm and seeing the bees. And I was so inspired by seeing the bees. They're such hard workers. So many of you commented that you enjoyed that. I'm kind of thinking I might want to delve into beekeeping. What do you think? So I'm looking for an easy way to do it in an urban setting. There's bee classes that are near us at Topanga Nursery in Southern Cal. So I really want to research it. Let me know if you'd like to see beekeeping content here on our channel. I'm brand new to it, but I'm pretty excited about it. I kind of got hooked on it, honestly, seeing how hard those bees work. So I thought today, let's talk a little bit more about bees as far as what we can do to support the bees during fall and winter. So I'd love to hear any of your tips too. I'm sure some of you out there might be beekeepers and can help contribute to the conversation. But once I started doing some research, I realized that bees actually kind of hibernate in the hive, honeybees anyway, hibernate in the hive for the winter, at least maybe not hibernate, but just clump together to stay warm, because they really don't do too well under, I believe it's 45 or 50 degrees. So right now in the fall, they're heading out for their foraging trips and trying to find pollen and nectar to help sustain them through the winter time. So I thought, why not do a live stream on how, what we can do right now in the fall to help support them in the winter. So come spring, we've got plenty of bees to pollinate our vegetables. Because if you think about it, bees are such a critical link, not only to our own gardens and producing tons of fresh fruit and veggies, but also the food supply of the entire world. So they're very, very important, tiny little insects that we definitely want to support as much as we can. And we do talk a lot about how to bring pollinators to our garden, but right now it's super important. And Santa Ana Road Wildman, yes, save the bees. Michelle is saying yes, 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 bees. Jerry saying hardly any bees here this summer. So yeah, I have heard from a lot of different people that they were struggling with bees in their garden this year. Ramona, I like bees. I think I'll get someone to tend to my beehive. Have you heard of horizontal beehives? I have. Actually, Jason was telling me a little bit more about that. So that'll definitely be something I'll be researching, and hopefully be bringing you some more bee content coming up in the next several months. So let me jump into my first tip, and in between the chat, if you're in between the tips, if you're brand new here, I jump into the chat, take questions, take comments. So definitely if you have any bee ideas or suggestions, pop them down in there and we'll go through the chat as much as we can. Jack, how you doing? Tons of bees on his Thai basil. It's great to see you, Jack. Thanks for all your awesome comments over on Instagram. Okay, little side note here. I think Kelly Camera Guy made the best Instagram reel ever. A lot of you have seen that. You got to head over to either Cali Camera Guy's Instagram or mine at CaliCam29 and check it out. It was definitely an experience of a lifetime we had yesterday, right out in the water behind us. Okay, back to bees, all right? So I'm going to be looking off to the side here. Excuse me while I grab my mouse. Looking off the side here where I have my monitor. And let's talk about tip one. And that is, and I think Jack kind of mentioned this right now, is plant or let some herbs, veggies, and greens flower, okay? Bees absolutely love the flowers of like basil, Thai basil. The bees love the flowers on Thai basil. They love like when your kale or your chard goes to flower, any of your vegetables that might be bolting, even your greens, if you have any lettuce going and it goes to flower and seed, you know, it shoots that tall stalk up in the middle. The bees love those flowers. So now kind of in the shoulder season of gardening for a lot of you northern gardeners, you're starting to, your warm weather crops are starting to fade. You might be starting to pull some things out. Leave some things in. Let your basil go to flower and go to seed, any parsley or cilantro, let a couple of them flower and go to seed, and you will be amazed at how many more bees come in. They love especially the basil flowers. Thai basil or the Italian basil, they will flock to those flowers like crazy. So don't be too quick to yank everything out. It's always good to get things cleaned up. You know, your tomatoes and your cucumbers and things like that that might be browning and wilting and dying, especially in the heat that a lot of us have experienced this summer. But if you still have some of those herbs and greens growing, leave them in, let them flower, and really support the bees. They're going to be gathering up pollen and nectar from all those flowers, and then not only coming into your garden more, which is always beneficial to us, but then actually taking that pollen and nectar back to the hive and storing up for winter. So that's one really simple way that we can support the bees. Another herb I just thought of that I actually grew this summer for the first time, and do you guys see that little bird back there on the palm tree? It's just the most adorable little bird. We hear it chirping all the time. We're sitting out here watching it kind of fly around. I'm not sure if it has a nest right there, but it really seems to enjoy that palm tree. So you might want to keep an eye on that during our live stream. But anyway, one herb I grew this summer is fennel. And I wasn't too successful harvesting the fennel bulbs because it does like the cooler weather, and it just kept bolting and going to seed and flowering. But I left it in for a long time. You might have seen it on our garden tours, and the bees just flock to it like crazy. So hopefully next year I'll be, or maybe over the winter months, I'll be able to grow some fennel and actually harvest the bulbs. Ramona, that's a great one. I forgot about mint. My mint is flowering, Ramona says, and my autumn joy plant has every variety of bees all over it. That's awesome. Lavender, salvia, Nisha, those are great flowers that attract the bees. And those are all wonderful things to bring those bees in. So the mint flowers, it's great to have a mint in a container and maybe let one container flower and then trim one container back, because mint will keep coming back time after time, even if you think it's completely dead or forgot to water it, like I have many a time in a container. Chop it back, leave one to flower, chop the other one back, and then you'll have mint. In a southern climate, you can grow mint year round. So back into the chat here, guys, and let's see what all is going on here. If you have any bee suggestions. Melody, great to have you here today. Here in Jamaica, when we have too much rainfall and not enough pollen, we give the bees brown sugar, and that's for the bee farmers. That's awesome. Great tip. If there's not enough food for the bees, I know a lot of times the beekeepers will give the bees some food to help sustain them and help keep them going and help them produce the honey. So I think one of my favorite parts of the bee video with Jason was when he popped into that capped off honeycomb and the honey just kind of came flowing out. Was that awesome or what? And I cannot tell you guys how delicious that honey was. I was a little bit nervous to open my bee suit, but Jason quickly popped that honey into my mouth. That was kind of funny when we went back to watch that. And I'm telling you guys, as Jason said to me, it's like happiness on the tongue. So it was incredible. So I kind of want to have that in my own garden too. So if there's any beekeepers here, I would love to hear from you in the chat as well. It would be awesome to just to have your suggestions. 808 Ladybug, how are you doing, Ladybugs? We let our fennel, basil, and chives. I forgot about chives. Great suggestion. Flower for some bees. So yeah, and it looks beautiful in your garden when you have your herbs flowering. So you know, leave some to harvest and leave some to flower, and it's a win-win for everyone. So D. Reed, how are you doing? Thanks so much for sharing. Love your products. Thank you. Donna in Texas, my pollinator packet from you went crazy. That's awesome, Donna. So glad to hear that. I love it when I hear that kind of feedback. We do have lots of pollinator packets on our seed and garden shop that you can grab to help support the pollinators. Lots of flower packets. And today's the last day for the 25% off sale with the code BEES. So still sending out orders, even though we're here in Maui, got the home front working. We're here working remotely, but go over to calikimgardeninghome.com, enter the code BEES, and you get 25% off your seed packets, your Calikim Smart Pots, and signed copies of my book. So start that Christmas shopping early, because believe it or not, Christmas is right around the corner. Tina D, bees love St. John's wort. Yes, they do. They love that as well. There's so many things you can plant for the bees. Dogwood flowers from Juan makes great honey for bees. Thank you, Urban Chicken Mama. Your seeds are great. So glad you're enjoying them. And let's jump back and talk about our second tip. Okay, if you're in a northern garden, this is a good tip, especially for you, is right now is the time where you're gonna wanna be planting bulbs, okay? Plant your fall bulbs, because what happens when you plant your bulbs in the fall? They like that cold period of winter dormancy over the winter time. They'll get covered with snow. You're not gonna see growth out of them in northern climates over the winter, but come spring, get a couple warm days, and those bulbs like tulips, daffodils, hyacinths, I wrote down a couple other ones. Oh, the crocuses, who can forget the crocuses? They bloom early, early, early in the spring. In fact, it's one of the first signs of spring, is you'll see those little spring bulbs kind of poking through the soil, even through the snow. If your ground is still covered with snow, is those are the very first bulbs to bloom. So it's kind of a sign of spring. And it gives a really early food source for the bees. So they're gonna be coming out of their hives as the weather, as the days are warming up, going out foraging into your garden, which is awesome when you see those first bees come in the spring, and they're gonna be looking for those early blooms. So if you've got your bulbs planted now, you've gotta plant them in the fall, and then they're gonna be blooming in the spring. I know it's hard to wait, isn't it? Did you guys hear that? Isn't that amazing? That tropical bird is just like, oh my gosh, beautiful. Anyway, they're gonna appreciate that so much. They'll reward your garden, pollinate your vegetables, and they'll go back to their hives and produce more of that fresh local honey that we all love. So definitely get those bulbs planted, and there's lots and lots of online sources for that. I don't have bulbs at my seed shop. Check in your local nursery. It's always fun to look at, to support your local garden center. So if you have a local family-owned garden center, support them first. Check them out for bulbs. You can also look online. And also support your local beekeeper by purchasing raw local organic honey, as Jason mentioned in the Maui Bee Farm video. So get your bulbs planted. Let me know in the chat here what bulbs you enjoy planting in the fall. And I mentioned a few, but let me know what you enjoy planting. And I think it'll kind of lift your spirits too to see those first little blooms poking through the soil in spring. Now, can you guys believe we're already talking about winter? It's crazy. But yes, we are. And it's a good way to beat the winter blues by planting something now and supporting the bees through the fall and winter. Okay, let's see here what's going on in the chat. Okay, thank you so much, Michelle. Love, love your book. I highly recommend it. Thank you so much. Which one are you reading? The Organic Gardening for Everyone or the Raised Bed Gardening book? So let me know which one. Hopefully you're enjoying both of them. Ramona Jolly, that was beautiful. Such a heavenly sound. It is. And I couldn't agree with you more, Ramona. There's so many just heavenly little bits and pieces of Maui that we've been enjoying. We feel so blessed to be able to be here and to invite you along to share it with us. Okay, Ramona also plants lots of tulips and daffodils. Those are so beautiful. The blooms are short-lived, but man, they sure are amazing. And there's so many different varieties of tulips anyway. I'm sure there are of daffodils too, but tulips are the main ones that I've seen different varieties of. Okay, let's see here, Jack. Oh, some kind of a tsunami warning or something like that somewhere. I don't think here. Pony Girl, thank you so much for that reminder. For backyard bees, inform neighbors so they don't spray insecticides which could harm or kill your backyard bees. So always a great suggestion there. You definitely want to avoid any chemical insecticides or pesticides in your garden, especially if you're going to be doing some beekeeping. Okay, let's scroll back through here and see what else we have. And Urban Chicken Mama, I'm afraid I'm going to hit the bulbs that are already there. I planted a couple hundred last year. Wow, that's crazy. So you must have a beautiful spring bloom there in your garden. I bet that's incredible, along with your chickens there, of course. Okay, so let me talk about tip number three. Oh, before I forget, I want to talk a little bit about our live stream schedule. So we've been off for most of the month of September. Today is actually the only live we're going to be doing in September. Next Monday, we have another special something that we're going to be shooting and bringing to you next week. So our next live stream will actually be the 3rd of October. And October will be a normal, back to our normal Monday live stream schedule. So next Monday we're off. The following Monday is already October. October 3rd will be our very next live stream. So mark that on your calendars and make sure you join us on October 3rd, but not next week, okay? All right, so tip number three for your planting for the bees right now in the fall. And I'd say this is especially for you southern gardeners, okay? You southern gardeners. So by a southern gardener, what I mean is those of you that are in the southern part of the US or the world, not necessarily the southern hemisphere, but just people who basically aren't getting a hard frost during the winter. You live in a temperate winter climate, warm temperatures compared to your northern gardeners, and you get a light frost, if any. So those gardeners can grow year round. Wintertime is often a really great time to grow the cool weather vegetables. But it's like our in the fall garden seed collection, but especially right now, besides planting your fall garden, don't forget to plant your cool season flowers. Now we have a whole cool season flower collection that bring in the pollinators that you can grab over at CallieKimGardenAndHome.com. But some of my favorites, if you've watched our channel for any length at all, you know how much I love nasturtiums. Those are probably one of the easiest cool season flowers to grow. They don't take a frost though. So if you're gonna risk it a little bit if you get light frosts, which sometimes we do in California, but if they do get bitten by frost, they grow right back if you trim them off. So bees absolutely love nasturtiums and they bloom in profusion. It's getting a little bit windy behind me. So let's hope that my tripod stays upright. But they bloom in profusion, especially in the cooler months. Great one to pop in. You also wanna plant some, just looking on my list here so I don't forget. You also wanna plant some calendula. Bye Jack, have a great day. Thanks for hanging out here with us. Have a fun class. You also want to plant calendula. I do have calendula in my cool season flower collection. They are beautiful yellow. There's probably different colors, but my cool season collection has the yellow calendulas. They bloom profusely. They have a very long blooming season. You can trim off the spent flowers, which I call deadheading, and they'll continue to bloom pretty much all winter. So for you southern gardeners, it's great to plant those so the bees, when they do go out, because they will continue going out in warmer climates to forage, that they'll have something in your garden to grab some pollen or some nectar from. A couple other ones, excuse me, that are really, really nice. The dahlias in my garden are still going strong. Those are something you'd want to plant in the springtime for fall and possibly winter blooming. My zinnias are still going strong. You southern gardeners might still get a round of zinnias out of things, excuse me. The alyssum and the forget-me-nots. Now bees love the alyssum. I have the white alyssum all over my garden. There's also purple alyssum. They really enjoy that. And they alyssum kind of carpets the area and kind of, trails. You can put it trailing over pots. It'll trail over landscapes. It could be good ground cover on a hill. You can trim it back. It grows back very quickly and it comes back year after year. So alyssum is definitely one of my favorites. It's beautiful, teeny tiny little white flowers. The bees absolutely love it. So I saw a couple other comments here in the chat. Nasturtiums are my favorite from Patricia Treadway. V loves calendulums, a super easy one. Couldn't agree more. Irene, great to have you here. So glad that you're here. And Nisha, thank you so much for mentioning sweet pea flowers and mums. Mums are a great fall flower to plant. You can find transplants in garden centers all over the place right now in so many colors. They make a great landscaping plant. You can plant them directly in the garden. I've had some of my containers of mums for probably 2 or 3 years. You cut them off. I have a video on how to prune mums for continual blooms, but they come back like crazy once you deadhead them. And that really is the key, is keeping them pruned. And that way you continue to have a continual bloom in your garden, not only for the color, but for the bees. So it's kind of good to plant flowers that bloom at different times. So there's always, always something there. Urban Chicken Mama, snapdragons in pots. This year is so pretty. And Santa Ana Road Wild Man, they start from seed easily. Are you talking about mums? I've actually never started mums from seed. So if anyone here has started them from seed, let me know. The other ones I mentioned, the nasturtiums, the calendula, the alyssums, Start very easily from seed. So grab one of those cool season flower collections and you are good to go on that one. Forget-me-nots are a beautiful purple, kind of a delicate looking flower. They can grow to a couple of feet tall. They're definitely one of my all-time favorite cool season flowers. And don't forget the cool season herbs too, like the cilantro and the parsley. They may not flower in the cool season, but they're great ones to pop into your garden here in the cool season as well. So let me know here in the chat what are your favorite cool season flowers, but definitely get some planted, especially for you southern gardeners, right now. And that way you have some that bloom over the winter time. You northern gardeners, you may not be able to get them to bloom before the cold weather hits. You may not have quite enough time for that, but it doesn't hurt to get those bulbs in and to throw some seeds down for early spring bloom as well. Another thing I forgot to mention is the wildflowers. I always throw wildflowers down every winter time and they come up once the weather warms up a bit in the spring. So that's always a good one, is to get a good wildflower mix. I've got a couple of good wildflower seed packets in my my flower packs, some red ones, some perennials, and they grow absolutely beautifully come springtime. They just pop into life. So let me know here in the chat what you love to plant flower-wise to support the bees in your garden. And I just saw someone, hello boars, that's a great suggestion, Urban Chicken Mama. Love that. I saw a suggestion about calendula, and I'm trying to see where that was. Great for skin and health products. Thank you so much, Patricia. I've never used it for skin and healthcare products. I've never looked for it as an ingredient, but I'll definitely have to start doing that. And Ramona is saying 1 quart of honey costs $19. Wow. It would be nice to one day have my own honey, but in the meantime, the farmer's market is my honey spot. So yeah, look around, just support your local beekeepers. Some of them might have various prices, but definitely also very, very good for your health besides being delicious to eat. We've been buying local sourdough bread that's made locally and then putting the raw honey on it on toast in the morning. It is out of this world. And it's also great to top your yogurt berry bowls with. Sprinkle a little organic granola on top of your berries and yogurt and put some raw organic honey on it. And it is out of this world and very, very healthy. Santa Ana Road Wildman would like those huge Day of the Dead styled marigolds. Those are pretty cool. They're huge, huge blooms. And those are great, easy to grow to bring in the bees as well. Great idea, V. Been saving calendula flowers to make soaps. That's awesome. And God of the Sun, Jesus Christ saves. We have a farmer's market here on Maui up in Kula. Great to see you here. A local farmer here in Maui. So we did see a couple of those farmer's markets up there. And we'll definitely head up that way and stop by one for sure. Okay, Urban Chicken Mom have been deadheading the marigolds, toxing them back in the bed and hoping they come back next year. I think you're going to be in luck. I've done that too, and I have had some regrow. Stephanie, bees love borage. There's so many great suggestions for bees here. Borage is in my warm season pollinator pack as well. So thank you, Stephanie, for bringing that one out. Okay, let's talk about tip number four. And I love this one. I've seen it in practice in my own garden. And that is when you're planting for the bees, and this isn't necessarily just a fall tip, but something you can do anytime year round, is plant your flowers in clumps. Okay, so bees do love certain colors. They love purple, they love white, they love yellow, and they're looking for those flowers in your garden. So they're gonna see them a lot more if you plant your flowers in clumps, say 3 to 4 feet in width. That way they can see the flowers, they can go right to them, and it's gonna be a much more efficient way for them to go out on their little foraging expeditions and collect the pollen and nectar they need to pollinate your vegetables, but then also to take back to the hive. So that's going to be a much more efficient way for them to go, rather than if you have one flower scattered here, one flower scattered there. There's nothing wrong with that, but definitely plant some flowers in clumps. And if you've seen my cut flower garden on some of our garden tours, perfect example, or the nasturtiums that we have spilling over the garden beds in the springtime. Wide swaths of color. The sunflowers, wide swaths of color. The zinnias in the cut flower garden, lots and lots of color. That's one reason why I did that entire area this year with flowers, because the bees come in, they're all over it, the butterflies are all over it, there's pollinators going crazy, and then they go over to your vegetables to pollinate your squash, your tomatoes, your cucumbers, and then they're taking a lot of that pollen back to their hives and producing the local honey, which is amazing. So they are just absolutely fascinating the way they work together. Each one has their role. And if you saw the bee video when Jason pulled out the bee frames, you saw how they were each doing something. You've got the drones, the worker bees, the queen. I mean, they all know their jobs. They're all working as a team. And they're heading out to pollinate our gardens as well. So plant in clumps. Okay, let me know if you've been planting in clumps in your garden, how that's working for you, if it has brought more bees in to your garden. And Nisha, thank you so much. They love blue, purple, violet, white, and yellow. All those are great colors to plant, which are a lot of the colors in my the giant zinnia packs that we have. The zinnias are amazing for bees. Lots of different colors in there, from the salmon zinnias, the scarlet flames, the California giants, the lily puts. They're all some of my favorites in that seed packet. Okay, let's see here. Charlene, I've sowed borage a few weeks ago, never tried before. Charlene, you're gonna love it. It's gonna do really well in your garden there in Spain. Borage are teeny tiny little almost star-shaped flowers. It's actually an herb, kind of smells like cucumber. But the great thing about borage is not only do the bees absolutely love it, you'll be amazed at how many more bees you get with borage, but they reseed. So I think I planted borage one time probably 8 to 10 years ago when we first started our garden here, and it just reseeds like crazy year after year. So, and it grows very well in the heat, and then you can cut it back, and a lot of times it will keep on growing in California for the winter time. Okay, yeah, beautiful flowers. It's edible. A lot of the flowers in my pollinator packets are edible as well. The zinnias, the borage, the calendula, a lot of them are edible. So if in doubt, though, definitely look it up and Google it. Okay, let's see, I just saw a question here. Where is it? My sunflower dropped from was it Urban Chicken Mama? Tina, it's 10 feet tall. That's crazy, crazy, crazy. And Jerry, are there any flowers that should not be planted with vegetables? You know, I really can't think of any. I know there's some that maybe are toxic to pets. So that's some that you would want to look up and research if that's a concern for you. However, I actually get that question a lot, and it's actually a really good idea to interplant your flowers with your vegetables. No danger in that, because not only does it look beautiful, it's gonna lift your spirits, but the bees will come into your vegetables exactly where you want them. They're gonna come in for the flowers, pollinate the flowers, grab the pollen from the flowers, and then pollinate your vegetables as well. So always a good thing to do. Borage reseeds and takes over. It does love to spread out. I wouldn't necessarily say it's invasive, not like mint or anything like that, but it does like to spread. It can trail over garden beds. It's really a beautiful like filler plant if you need a spot where you need to fill, a garden bed that you need to fill, you don't want to plant vegetables in. It's a beautiful, beautiful crop to plant. I have edible, this is from God the Sun, Jesus Christ Saves. I have edible hibiscus that love the jungle area around my house. So many beautiful tropical flowers here in Maui, and I'm sure those look absolutely stunning. We're really enjoying the tropical flowers. And Cliff, thank you so much. Miracles are the most recognizable flower associated with the Day of the Dead flower, believed to lure souls back from the dead with their vibrant colors and scents. That's awesome. So fascinating. Nisha has zinnias, marigolds, borage, sunflowers, salvia, black-eyed Susan, and alyssum in a raised bed. That's awesome, Nisha. You're packing in there and bringing in the blooms, bringing in the bees and the blooms. Okay, the sunflower is a heavy nitrogen user. I thought you shouldn't plant them with things like tomatoes. You know, I really haven't had any issues with that, Urban Chicken Mama. And I do not even really even water my sunflowers, and we get no rain. I haven't fed them anything all summer long. They're doing great, and I haven't really had any huge issues with that. So, you know, give it a try. See what works or what doesn't work for you. It's always great to experiment when it comes to those kinds of things too. Eileen, great to have you here. Getting here late, no worries. Wish I was in Hawaii with you. Wish you all were too, and that's why we're bringing it to you here on the live stream. and through our YouTube and social media. Okay, I'm gonna share one more tip, and I almost forgot this one, but I usually do this year after year, and that is during the winter time and the fall right now, for just about any gardener, no matter where you live, it's a great time to plant cover crops. And I've got a video we did, I believe last fall on this, on planting cover crops in your garden to feed your garden and also help feed the bees. It's a very important thing to do, especially as you might be clearing out some of your garden beds for the winter. You don't want to leave your soil bare. And that's because, you know, you're going to get precipitation, rain, maybe snow over the winter time. It's going to cause your soil to erode. The nutrients can really, you know, leach out over the winter time. You've used a lot of nutrients up over the growing season by what you planted. So plant some cover crops that are, the purpose is to not necessarily for food production, but to cover your soil, to add organic matter to your soil, to feed your soil over the winter time. But it also provides a really important food source for the bees. So easy to grow cover crops. You probably already have seeds for these from your spring planting and summer plantings. Clover, that might not be one that you have, but those are easy to find online or at your garden centers, clover seeds. You might have them in your lawn, clover in your lawn, either red clover or white clover. The bees love that, and it's also a good source for your garden beds. Any legumes like peas, beans and peas that grow quickly, fava beans are great. Peas are something we grow in California in the wintertime anyway. Those are provide a great nitrogen source for your soil. And then when they bloom, the bees will come into your garden and it'll give them something to feed on and to pollinate as well. So those are just a couple of suggestions. I know there's lots of other grasses you can plant, like vetch and the other names of rye, I think is another one of the grass you can plant. Even lettuces, even though they may not bloom, it will be good cover crops just to cover your soil. And then come springtime, you do something called chop and drop, where you chop down those crops. You leave them in the garden beds to kind of rot and compost into the soil. So it gives your soil organic matter, and it's just kind of a win-win for everyone. Brings in the bees. The bees can take the pollen from the flowers, go back to their hives, and have something to feed on over the winter time. Super easy to do, and a lot of people just associate that maybe with large farms, but as backyard gardeners, we can do it in a very simple way as well. Mustard greens, thank you, Nisha, for reminding me of that one. That one is a beautiful, beautiful green, and it also, when it flowers, the bees absolutely love them. And I've got giant red mustard greens. I think it's several of my seed collections, a good couple ones to grab at this time of the year. The bring on the pollinators, cool. The specialty greens have a lot of beautiful specialty greens for the winter time. Microgreens, which you can grow inside, and if you're getting ready for indoor gardening, if it's getting too cold, or it will be cold too, the indoor garden seed collection, those are great ones to grab. And of course, fall right now, because a lot of us are still planting our fall vegetables. I just had my Cali Kim team member, Dana, who's working back at the shop, back at the house, plant my fall garden seeds inside. So when I get back, I'll have some seedlings ready to pop out in the garden. So grab those. Don't forget your 25% off with the code BEES. Last day to on that, okay? So here in the chat, let's see what you all are doing. Shared all my tips for bees. Let's see what you all are doing to help support the bees in your garden. And also what you're planting right now. What's the weather like? How is your garden doing? A lot of the southern gardeners just got through with a massive heat wave that swept through SoCal for a couple of weeks. So let me know how things are going in your garden, no matter where you live. Love to hear more about it as well. Okay, the Gardening Coast to Coast podcast, we're taking a hiatus from it for a couple of months. But you can go back and listen to all the old episodes or the episodes. I think we have 23 or something like that on there. So go check that out wherever you listen to podcasts. And I hope to see you at the market, but I won't be at the Kula Farmers Market this Saturday. Have a great trip. Mohammed, hi from Egypt. Awesome to see people from all over the world. So exciting. And Sphinx saying hi to you. Hi there. I avoid to use any chemical pesticides from 2 years, and I planted many flowers to save the bees such as hibiscus and mixed wildflowers. That's awesome. Wildflowers are amazing for the bees. And hibiscus too, we've been seeing a lot of those here. Okay, Ashley, I hope you two are having fun. We definitely are having a great time. Smile Urban Gardens uses rye as a cover crop. Great one, I'm glad that you mentioned that one. Rocky, how you doing, Rocky? Great to see you here. Great view of the beach. Yeah, we're really enjoying this. There's actually a beach on this side of us where we were snorkeling. We've been snorkeling almost every day. So here in Maui, at least where we're staying, it's nice and calm in the morning, very first thing in the morning. And it's actually, what time is it here? It's almost 10 a.m. here. So we're about 6 hours difference from the East Coast, 3 hours earlier than California. It's nice and calm in the morning. It's a great time to get outside and get in the water, which the water here is nice and warm. So we get our snorkeling gear on, we get out in the water and see some beautiful fish. The afternoons when the trade winds pick up, it gets super choppy out there. Not really a great time for swimming. So a lot of times we'll come back inside, work on our computers, get our work done, plan our content for the week, which we've got some great few videos coming up that we'll be shooting later in the week. Get our emails sent, check on things at home, see how things are going, and really enjoy the afternoon inside because it gets super windy. Or you might head out on a hike or to see the lavender farm, and you've seen some of those videos as well. So Barb Brownlee, thank you so much. Enjoying the live tips and scenic views. Enjoy your working vacation. Have a blessed, healthy, and safe day, everyone. Thank you so much, Barb. Really appreciate that. And Santa Ana Road, wow, man, it's normal for Gilroy, but cooking for Hollister. So stay cool up there. Hopefully you're able to get your fall garden planted soon. Angela, how's it going there? Just planted some blueberries in smart pots yesterday. Have peas going in the garden. Maybe I'll do some mustard greens as cover for the winter. That's a great idea. And I'm so glad that Nisha mentioned that because that is one of my very favorite cover crops. Very easy to grow. You can pick some for greens and then leave some to flower for the bees as well. And it just grows crazy in the cooler months. Now for you northern gardeners too, something I should mention is once you get your fall garden in and established, that's why it's so important to get those fall garden seeds planted now. Once you get those roots established in the ground, a lot of times they're gonna survive the first few frosts of the winter time, especially if you put some really simple winter covers over your containers or garden beds. If you get really into it and go all out and build some type of a cold frame with a heavier layer of protection like a glass cover or a harder sided plastic cover or even a greenhouse, a lot of times you can get those cool weather crops to grow all winter, even in really cold northern climates. So do a little bit of research, but definitely get your fall seeds planted. Now is the time, even for you southern gardeners, get those seeds started. You northern gardeners may want to plant some in containers that you could bring indoors as well, so you have some of those greens growing. So plan now for the colder months. I know that during the colder months, those of us who are in warm climates can still grow, but you snowy people, it gets a little tough in the winter sometimes. We get the winter blues sometimes. So plan now to avoid that. Get some things going that you can either bring inside or start microgreens or herbs or a couple little 5 gallon smart pots and plan now so that you don't get hit with those winter blues this winter time. So Camera Guy, you want to come out for the end of the live stream? We'll probably close it out here in just a couple minutes, but let us know what you're enjoying about your garden, either what you're enjoying about the videos or what you're enjoying and finding peace and a little mental break right now in your own garden. And we really do appreciate your support, your kindness. Your comments just mean the world to us, and we read every single one and answer as many as we possibly can. So Camera Guy, step back in here.
Yes.
And we really do appreciate you all and your love and kindness and support. Environmental totally. Coffee House, thank you. And enjoyed the show today, Callie, Kim, and Camera Guy. I'm so happy to hear that.
Let's see if we can give you all a nice shot of what's behind us. And we just can't touch the chat for a little bit.
Sure.
Because it resets the lighting. So
okay.
Let's step out and let's just see what happens.
Oh yeah, that's nice.
I'm going to move it a little bit. Here, if you want to look on your laptop.
Sure, yeah. It's nice. Maybe point it.
Some kayakers out there.
Point it out just a little bit more so we can. Oh yeah, there's a couple kayakers. The beach is kind of off to the. Maybe point it a little more that way, or. We usually watch the sunsets right out here in front of us every evening. And you might have caught my live stream, and maybe Jerry? I don't think Jerry did, but the sunsets are truly an event. People line up here along the beach and cheer literally as the sun goes down. So that's really fun to watch. A conch shell blows every evening, and it lasts for about an hour with the colors in the sky. So it's pretty darn cool. Well, there's some kayakers right there behind Jerry. So we'll try and do maybe another live stream during sunset, probably on Instagram, so that you all can see that as well. So it's been a great live stream. Great to be back. And remember, no live stream next week. We'll be back to our regular schedule on the 3rd of October. But make sure you're watching our Instagrams and YouTube videos in between. Lots and lots of fun content to come over the next couple of weeks that you do not want to miss.
That's right. Again, a little teaser here. We are going to be traveling soon for our next Show the World Your Garden.
That's right. So thanks for joining us. Don't forget to take advantage of the 25% off with the code BEES over at calikimgardenandhome.com. That does end at midnight Pacific time tonight. Have a great week. We'll see you all in 2 weeks.
Yes, see us over at Instagram, and you guys are all the best, all of you. Thank you so much.
All right, bye-bye.
Bye. Aloha, I should say.
Aloha and mahalo.